Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video we are going to see how we can decode any remote for TV, Blu-ray player, DVD player, whatever you have. So we will decode it using Arduino, get the code, and after that we will send using this infrared transmitter to control the same feature of this. For example, turn on the TV or turn it off. You can get the code for this project by clicking at the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Let's get started with this. When you press any button on your remote, actually it sends a code. And that code in 38 kilohertz, it's being decoded by the receiver. This is one of the example of the receiver, or maybe this one, which is in your TV or whatever device that the remote belongs to. So once the infrared signal receives there, it decodes it, and based on the different button that you press, it executes the command. For example, it turns off, turn it on, increase the volume, change the channel, whatever you do to control your TV. Let's say you want to turn it on and off, and this is, for example, I have a Samsung TV at home, which I'm going to test and show you. The on and off in TV works in such that if the TV is on and it receives the power signal, it will turn off, and if the TV is off, if it receives the power signal, it will turn on. So we are using only one code to control that, and I'm going to explain it to you. First step, we are, for example, turning on and off this TV. This is a Samsung TV. So we will use the power button and capture it. Volume and others, they will have two up and down. So we will use this one. We will capture only one code. I will show you how to do that. And after that, we will run this again as a transmitter, using this infrared transmitter. This is just LED type. It looks like an LED, but this is actually infrared, and we have only around 300 ohm resistor in between, and it will be just execute the code for us to turn the TV on and off. So there are two types of receivers sold on eBay. One is the actual receiver without a PCB. The other one is the module with the PCB, an LED that is related to the signal, so when it receives the signal, it blinks, it helps you. But my test will be on this one, and in this one we have here negative. This goes to the ground, the middle one goes to 5 volts, and there is on this side it says S. This goes to the signal. If you are getting this one, this side is flat and this side has this grid. This is the VCC ground, and this is the signal which you connect to pin 11, and this one, the signal also goes to pin 11. In both cases, if you're using this one or this one, I would suggest connecting it to pin 11. Otherwise, if you're changing the pin that you're connecting, make sure that it reflects it in the code. Now for this one, you have no choice but to connect this to pin 3, because the pin has been defined in the library. If you want to change it, you have to open the library and change it. This resistor is 300 ohm, and you can put 270 up to 320, and these values, all of these will work. The only difference is if you put higher resistance, the power of this will be reduced and it will work for the shorter range. But if you increase the power up to certain range, depending on the specification of this, let's say if you reduce it, the value of this, the power will increase, and eventually this will be damaged if you send more voltage to this. 270 to 300 ohm resistor will be suitable for this one. Otherwise, consult the data sheet for the receiver and calculate resistors accordingly. The first thing that you need is to download the library for the remote control. I will give you the link for that, so you have to download and include it. Once you include it in your library, if you go on File, Example, and then there will be IR Remote, you will see all of this. If you see all of this, then you have the library and we are good. So this will work automatically as soon as you have the library. Anything that you need to change is here, which pin you are receiving the signal from the receiver. So this is pin 11. If you want to use other pin, just change it. Other than that, You do not change anything in this code. We're just using it as a decoder. So you will set the right pin here. I'm using pin 11 to receive the signal from the receiver. Other than that, you don't do anything here. And once you run it, it will just display the code to you. This is connected, turned on, and that's the sketch. Let's just upload it. To send the code, go to File, Example, IR Remote, and then use this one, Send Raw Demo. Open this, and now the code that they give you, just paste it here. Delete all of this inside the loop, and I just left 5,000 millisecond delay. I just pasted it. Now you see the raw, this is the array that is holding the code for the remote. This long, it has so many elements already there. And the name of this array is raw, and it has 68 elements. Here we say send raw, then the array named raw, and then it 68 is the length, and then 38 is the frequency. If we send this, and if we connect, now we don't need to have this receiver, we can remove it. If you want to leave it also, that's fine. Done, and if I upload it, now the code is uploaded. Now every 5,000 millisecond or 5 seconds, this sends a signal. The TV is in the other room, and we are going to turn the TV off, and then if it's on, will be off, and wait 5 seconds and turn it on. But before going to that room, let's just use the, I will use another Arduino to decode this and see if we are getting the same code. I'm going to another port, port 8, which is this, now connected, upload the code, and then open serial monitor. Now this is sending the signal, and that one is receiving it. Okay, so we got this signal. Okay, so I'm just connecting it now. Let's see, the code that we got is the same code as the other one. F4B82988, and this is the code that we received. Exactly the way that we press this remote. Now this is acting as our remote. So I'm copying this. I'm copying this code that I received. And I'm going to paste it. And here there is some small difference. There are differences between the codes. And let's test it and see how it works with TV. Now I'm testing it. Here is my Arduino. The code is already uploaded, it's connected, turned on, and the transmitter is here, but I've not connected this. As you can see, the TV is off, and here is the remote. I'm going to leave it here. Now connecting this to pin 3. Now let's see if this turns the TV on. I heard the noise. The TV is on. And the TV is off, so it's perfectly working. And now 5 seconds passed, now it will turn the TV on again, and the remote is here. You can capture any TV or any device's remote and use Arduino to control your TV or whatever device you have. You can do more complicated. For example, you can have a satellite receiver, or let's say you have a Blu-ray player and you want to turn on the TV, and then after that turn on the Blu-ray player, set the input of the TV to, let's say, HDMI 1 or HDMI 2, and then play the Blu-ray. So and then set the volume at 50%. All of this can be done. So for each, you have to capture the code. For example, for input selection, press this, select the input. Let's say in your TV for HDMI 2, you're pressing this three times or two times until HDMI 1, HDMI 2, and then you capture that, put it in a sequence on your Arduino to be transmitted in here. And so you can have, I put here, I called it Samsung Power. So you can have these two line. Again, you will have Samsung input selection, and after that you can have another line for DVD player power, and then DVD player play. So whatever you have, we have 10, 20 lines you have, you can have it, and the Arduino can execute all those codes. Like this video, and also you learn something from this. Please thumb up the video, please also share it.